This is All India Radio. In the program Spotlight, now we bring you a discussion on minimum support price and procurement of crops by government for food security. The participants are Dr. A.K. Singh, Deputy Director General, Indian Council of Agriculture Research, and Sanjeev Mukherjee, Journalist.
Dr. Singh, first which I would like to know from you is that what role exactly, according to you, has MSP played in the country's agricultural production and growth since the late 60s?
See, our country was actually having shortage of food grains, so the government gave certain incentives in the form of MSP so that farmers could grow it and the government could procure and also provide in the public distribution system. So it triggered a kind of production, the production which was needed for the food security of the country. Farmers grew and government procured all those which were grown by the farmers, and also created a buffer stock at the central level so that if any kind of calamity, any kind of warlike situation or floods or anything else, the countrymen could be provided food grains as and when it is required. So that it helped in facilitating cultivation of certain crops, and also it helped in terms of ensuring food security of the country. I mean to say that this is required also for a country like us, MSP, and that's why government time and again has been telling that MSP was, MSP is, and MSP will continue, because we need not a small quantity of food grains but a large quantity of food grain which is required to be produced by us so that we could feed our more than 1 billion population. The smaller countries can afford, they can buy from the other country, but we cannot afford because our consumption is quite huge and no other country can supply this much of amount of food grains which we are producing. That's why yesterday on the World Food Day, Honorable Prime Minister spoke that how agriculture has contributed and how agriculture scientists has contributed for the self-sufficiency in the country. So MSP is very important instrument in terms of food security, having a kind of employment and engaging large masses at the ground level. And that is why government is all the time emphasizing that it was and it will continue also in the future.
The MSP mechanism and the system and the scheme will continue as it is, and because the one thing we all know is that the PDS needs to be run, the MSP mechanism will continue. What, according to you, has been the spread of the MSP in the last few years? Because what we are hearing from several places is that MSP is now not only restricted to two crops or three crops. The government in the last 5-6 years, ever since 2014-15, has been buying a lot more other kinds of crops also under MSP.
From 2014 onwards, the government have emphasized on more procurement, and that is why we could find a kind of self-sufficiency in pulses. That the pulses production was around 16-17 million tons in 2016-17, but now it has gone around 25 million tons, and we say that we are self-sufficient in pulses. It happened because the government ensured that extra pulses will be grown by the farmers, that will be procured. And government procured also. I can give the figures that during 2009-14, as compared to 2009-14, and during this period 14-19, pulses procurement was more than 75 times. So that is indicative of the government's intentions that they are willing to continue this MSP system. And similarly, government is willing and trying to, same on the case of oilseeds, putting MSP and procuring pulses and encouraging farmers to grow for that. Same time, if you look into pulses, oilseeds and copra, the coconut, during 2019-14, the purchase was amount of 7.24 lakh million tons. But during 2014 and 2020, it has gone to 170.7 million tons. It is almost 24 times more as compared to the last 5 years and this current 5 years. So there is a lot of intentions, and also in case of purchase under PSS for the oilseeds pulses, MSP, which was earlier 2009-14, 3,10,000 crore, it has gone to almost 74,81,000 crore. So there is no comparison in terms of increase in the quantity and also the amount being paid by the government to procure. And government is doing quite strategically. Wherever the country is needing, wherever there is scarcity, government is trying to make it. I will again cite one example of paddy. During 2009-14, only 89.7 lakh million tons of Paddy was procured. But during 2014 to 20, 319 lakh million tons was purchased from Andhra Pradesh. So I mean to say that the government support is there for MSP. And also if you look into the current year, what the government has done this Rabi season itself, 2020, for the procurement of wheat, rice, pulses, oil seeds, it was to the tune of 1,13,000 crore on the MSP. And this amount is also almost 31% more than the 2019. So all the way government is trying to emphasize on the providing MSP to the farmers, more number of farmers, on more commodities which have been included. And government is even willing to create a kind of network by which the farmers are in a position to sell their produce anywhere. Even the farm bills which have come up as an act, I find that they will be supportive of the MSP also, because one ensures that the farmer can sell its produce anywhere. Yet the farmer has got the freedom to sell from anywhere, whether from home, from his own, you can say, go down, or from the field, which was not earlier. They have to bring only to the PMC markets, which are limited in number. And there were middlemen which were earning more, and then the farmer was not getting that kind of benefit. So that has been facilitated to the farmer, that he can sell from his produce from anywhere. And also it's a kind of benefit to the traders. They can also buy from any part of the country, from their own state, from the other state. So this is going to change the whole cropping systems also. The good thing which is going to happen, we say that in some ways you will find, particularly in the Indo-Gangetic plains, UP and Bihar and also Haryana and Punjab, only rice and wheat and some sugar cane is being grown, but more number of crops are not being grown. So that actually affects the human health also. There is no diversity in food, and also it is damaging the soil health and more water extraction, because these crops require a lot of water. So the government, this decision will be helping to facilitate a change in the cropping system, change in the food habits also. And that will be for the good for the human being, the countrymen. They will get more horticultural fruits, vegetables, and all kinds of oil seeds and pulses which are required for the human health. So I find that both are complementary to each other. The continuation of MSP, which government has said, and also APMC markets will be also continued. Government is all the time emphasizing. Same time, the government has come out with the creation of infrastructure of 1 lakh crore, which is going to facilitate many kind of things, including the micro food enterprises, I mean processing units, and that is the value addition units. And that's why almost 14 to 15% loss happens annually of the food grains which we are producing. That can be minimized by this kind of facilitation which is going to come through this kind of support by the government. Government is also trying to go for 100% vaccination of all the animals, because its vaccination is helping to the animals, but we also know that many of the diseases are coming from the animals to the humans. That will be also contributing to the human health. Similarly, there is going to be 10,000 farmers producer organizations, and we also know that there are small holders in this country, marginal and small farmers, and they need support by which they could do farming in clusters. Many farmers could come together. It could be a group farming, can be called. And then there is a provision of contract farming. So these groups coming together through FPO, they can come into contract with any buyer or any agency. And being a group, they will be able to bargain with those who are going to buy their produce. So these FPOs are also going to provide a kind of strength to the farming community.
Many people have been talking about is legalizing the MSP. How do you see that idea floating around?
Markets actually works on the demand and supply. If you look into dairy sector, all horticulture sector, there is no MSP right since the beginning. And market is deciding everything. And at the same time, you find these two sectors, horticulture and dairy and animal product sector, they are contributing more significantly towards the GDP. So there is an idea also that once the markets are open and there are more number of buyers, there will be competition now, and farmers will get better prices for this one. So at the same time, the government intervention will always there when the prices go quite low or even the prices go very high. and consumer suffers, then government can intervene and bring certain kinds of regulations. So that is a clause already there in the act itself. But I find that providing MSP network to the farmers on essential commodity is required, which is already being done by the government as per the requirements. We also know that whatever the requirement is for the procurement, almost three times more than that government has got in the buffer stock. So there is a limitation also at the government level that how much procurement can be made. Even Haryana government has come with a support to the farmers per acre 7,000 rupees. If they are diversifying from rice to wheat, from rice and wheat to oilseeds, pulses, vegetables, fruits. And we know that all these commodities are in shortage in the country. And if they are producing, then they will be getting better prices in the market. And government is also going to facilitate on the creation of warehouses, cold storages, and this will be all supported from the infrastructure development fund. Once this is created, all the facilities and storage is there, there will be price stabilization and also there will be less bungling. When farmers can procure for a longer period, once there is a storage facility for them, and whenever the market is suitable to be sold, then they will bring their produce in the market. So all the way I find that the act is facilitating farmers that they have not to pay any tax to the any kind of purchase by the buyer. So that is a big facilitation, and as of now almost 8%, 7% many of the state APMC mandis they are charging. So that will be a kind of support for the farmers. The transportation cost also will go down because farmer will be selling nearby. They have not to take the produce to the APMC market only, which is situated at a distance.
So the entire ecosystem looks very promising, and what we are now looking at is also diversification from not just growing wheat and rice but also to crops which we need more, like oilseed, pulses, vegetables, even dairy products, milk, eggs, fish, meat. All these, as you rightly said, are things that we need to consume more because that would push up our nutritional level with this thing. On this, coming back to on this MSP, the mechanism, as you said, has been very well established and has been working for long. How do you think the things will move forward from here onward after the bill come into force?
MSP is an instrument by which production of certain crops can be regulated by the government. And in any condition, government will be doing always enforcing MSP for certain commodities because we are a big country and we need a lot of food grains to be for feeding our own population. So MSP is going to be there. But at the same time, how the things is going to change in the years to come, I find that the markets will open up. Two things we have been telling in the agriculture sector. One is that we don't have the efficient marketing system. And this kind of facilitation is going to provide the marketing network throughout the country. We see the condition of the poor farmer who is going and selling the roadside. He doesn't have any place to sell in a good market. So once the buyer will establish their units in nook and corners of the country, so farmer will get a kind of facilitation. So marketing network will be strengthened. The other aspect, just I mentioned that we have been lacking the processing. And this infrastructure fund also tells that there is a huge 2 lakh units of micro food enterprises. So 2 lakh means almost every night and chat there will be one food processing unit, which will be a great boon for this country because as of now, processing is happening around 7 to 8% in our country. So once the processing will start with this infrastructure fund, so more prices will come to the farmers. There will be more holding capabilities once cold storages are there. So they would be not a panic kind of sell. They are producing and simply they are selling if they are not willing to. But the processing, marketing, storage, these three have been a weak link in the Indian agriculture sector. These three are going to be addressed by these three bills. And Essential Commodity Act also will trigger a better marketing, more purchases by the traders because it is limitless. They can buy as much they are willing. And at the same time, there is large number of people who are hungry and also they are malnutrition. That will be also addressed. So, and the diversification, what we are trying to tell, the malnutrition, the anemic condition in the women, what is persisting since long. So that can be also addressed once we start producing quality food, nutritious food, and our supply system that is support to those who are waiting for it. During this period only, 80 crore households were provided free food by the government. So it happened because we are growing and there is a support of the government through MSP, which supports farmers, which encourages farmers to produce those commodities where MSP is there.
I think that's a very valid point to end the discussion, that MSP is vitally needed for producing those essential commodities, which is needed for our PDS systems and also to improve the feed the people who actually need it. Thank you, Dr. Singh, for this enriching discussion on MSP and its impact and its history. And we look forward to seeing more from you. Thank you, Dr. Singh.
You were listening to a discussion on minimum support price and procurement of crops by government for food security. The participants were Dr. A.K. Singh, Deputy Director General, Indian Council of Agriculture Research, and Sanjeev Mukherjee, journalist. This program was produced and presented by the News Services Division of All India Radio. You can listen to it on our mobile app, News on AIR. This program is also available on our website, newsonair.com. You may email your opinion about this program at airnsdtalks@gmail.com.